فيتال فيزلز رابشر. فيتال فيزلز رابشر اكشلي از a rare but important cause of antepartum hemorrhage. Okay, it's mostly due to velamentous cord insertion. What is velamentous cord insertion? It's the blood vessels, okay, that inserted between the chorion and amnion, the membranes, okay, away from a placenta. Okay, normally the blood vessels should be inserted into the chorionic plate. Okay, let's just have some photo here. Okay, this is the chorionic plate. Okay, the normal blood vessels should be inserted here in the chorionic plate, but sometimes the blood vessels inserted between the chorion and amnion, these two layers of the uterus, chorion and amnion, okay, away from the placenta. This is the placenta. They are inserted away from the placenta, as you can see here, okay? This will lead to unprotected blood vessels in this area that, if ruptured, will cause antepartum hemorrhage, okay? This is velamentous cord insertion, and it's responsible for most of cases of fetal vessels ruptures, okay? And the risk factor behind velamentous cord insertion is multiple gestation, okay? The other, okay, just erase the lines that I have made. The other mechanism of fetal vessel rupture, which is uncommon, is succinturate blood vessels rupture, okay? In this case, the main bulk of placenta is in one portion of the uterine wall, okay? And a small rupture, okay, a small portion in other side, okay? And between these two portions, there are unprotected blood vessels that are prone to rupturing, okay? This is the uterus for just example, and this is the main bulk of placenta inserted in one part, okay? And other small part of placenta are inserted in other part of the uterine wall. Between this main bulk of placenta and this small placenta, there are some, just change the color to blood vessels, okay, that links these two. And these blood vessels are not protected. The blood vessels in placenta are protected, and in this small placenta are protected. But between them, the blood vessels are not protected, okay, and vulnerable to rupturing. Okay, here is a graph that show us the succinturate abnormal placentation or fetal vessel rupturing. This is the main bulk of placenta on the uterine wall, and other small part of placenta in other side, and between them or blood vessels that links the blood vessels that link these two parts together, okay? So this is a case of succinturate, okay? Just in these two cases, velamentous cord insertion or succinturate, we have unprotected blood vessels, okay? And these blood vessels may pass over the cervix, If they pass over the cervix, then we have a case of vasa previa. So vasa previa is not velamentous cord insertion by itself, and is not succinturate by itself. But if the blood vessels that are unprotected in these two cases pass over the cervix, then we have a case of vasa previa. These unprotected blood vessels are vulnerable to tearing, to laceration, and to shearing. So, because of that, we may have in a lot of cases fetal vessels rupturing in the case of velamentous cord insertion or suction. Okay, and the rupturing of these vessels will lead to bleeding, of course, and membrane rupture, because in vasa previa, for example, these vessels is inserted in the membranes. Okay, so any tearing to these vessels will cause membrane rupture, bleeding, and severe bradycardia. In the case of vasa previa, the presenting part of the baby will compress the blood vessels, and that will lead to asphyxia. By the way, 40-60% of vasa previa cases will die, so mortality rate is very high. It's a serious problem. How to diagnose fetal vessels rupture? Mostly after, and unfortunately, after heavy bleeding and fetal distress, the diagnosis is set. Okay, so diagnosis mostly is late. Okay, so and mostly also is seen after placenta inspection after the delivery. Okay, clinically, the symptoms are these three that we talked about: the bleeding, the bradycardia, severe fetus bradycardia, and the membrane rupture. Doppler ultrasound is of importance here to diagnose the velamentous cord insertion or the vasa previa. Okay, so it's important and can detect these conditions, but the problem is that we have no routine Doppler ultrasound screening. But if in antenatal care, the doctor should take care of cord insertion. Is it in the cord plate or chorionic plate or not? So if it is not in the chorionic plate, then Doppler should be done to detect the presence of these conditions. Okay, F-test to know is it the fetal blood or the mother blood, and that this test is done during the bleeding by adding water and NaOH to the blood. If it is if turns into pink, then it is the fetus blood. If yellow to brown, then it is the mother blood. Okay, how this is how to diagnose the fetal vessels rupture, and as I said, unfortunately, it's it's common to diagnose these conditions after severe distress of the fetus and after delivery also. Okay, so how to treat these causes? The treatment is immediate cesarean section. Now let's move to the last condition that is responsible for antepartum hemorrhage, uterine rupture. Uterine rupture is also a rare condition, but also an important condition because of its dangerosity. Okay, and uterine may rupture during or before labor. What is the uterine rupture? It is complete separation of the wall of the pregnant uterus. So it's separation of the wall of the uterus. Okay, this separation may or may not be associated with expulsion of fetus or some fetal parts. Okay, we divide the uterine rupture into two parts, or two types: the complete uterine rupture or incomplete uterine rupture. In complete uterine rupture, we have visceral peritoneum rupture also. In incomplete uterine rupture, the visceral peritoneum is preserved. Okay, we have no visceral peritoneum rupture. What are the risk factors of uterine rupture? The most important one is the classical cesarean section. And the classical cesarean section is 20 times more prone to rupture than normal cesarean section. Okay, multiparity also the risk factor for uterine rupture. Uterine distension is also very important, because in uterine distension the uterus will be more vulnerable to rupture. Okay, what is the presentation of uterine rupture? Of course, pain, sudden severe pain, bleeding of course, and loss of CTG. okay, in monitor, in heart, fetal heart monitor, we will see isoelectric line. Okay, nothing else. Okay, so this is the presentation of uterine rupture. How to diagnose uterine rupture? The confirmatory diagnosis is by surgical exploration of the uterus, and the treatment of uterine rupture is by immediate surgical delivery. Because it's important and a dangerous situation. Okay, and after the delivery, we may repair the uterus by suturing it if we have an intention to conceive, or if there is no intention to conceive, then we have to do a hysterectomy. Hysterectomy is the solution in this case. This is the last subject on antepartum hemorrhage. We talked about ruptured placenta, placenta previa, and fetal vessels rupture and uterine rupture as the last subject. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.